Welcome to my video demonstration. I want to show you how to use the SimCenter Magnetics Solver to solve for 3D electromagnetic motors. Electric motors are often simulated in 2D only. 3D effects play a larger role only if motors are small in the axial direction, like this one. Other reasons for 3D simulation can be to check for leakage flux, or maybe if there are magnet overhangs or eccentricities. This example shows 2D and 3D simulation in comparison. What you see here is a typical electric motor that is used for automotive applications. You see a skeleton file that contains the basis of the cut design. The skeleton controls both the 2D and the 3D cut model and also the finite element model. Only one segment is used. You see that both the 2D as well as the 3D model are derived from this skeleton. Let's look at the 2D FEM solution. This 2D FEM solution is used for fast simulations and for sizing. We go back to the 3D model now. The skeleton is also linked to the 3D model and it is used there as a wave link, and this one is the backbone for the following cut features. We go to the finite element model for the 3D now. This finite element model contains one pole pair. There are meshes, material properties, and nonlinear properties. We go to the properties of the stator. Take a look at the electromagnetic material properties. There is a nonlinear BH curve that describes the relationship of flux density to field strength. We take a look at the coils. Go to the properties of the coils. The material is set to copper. The conductor model is set to stranded. The number of turns and the fill factor is given. Now we change to the simulation file. Let's take a look into the solution and check for the outputs that we request. We use the solver magnetics, and in this case we use a magnetostatic solution. The tabular outputs and the plot outputs and several different types of outputs. 72 number of time steps. What you see here is the so-called enforced joint that defines the motion. Then we see constraints, we link the both sides left and right with some special constraints, and now we look at the three-phase electric current. We give the current amplitude and a frequency and a phase shift. Now we go to the tabular results and we compare those results from the 2D analysis with those from the 3D analysis. First thing we check is the flux linkage results. Now we want to check for the torque result, and we want to see both the 2D as well as the 3D torque result. You see the blue curve is the one from the 2D analysis and the red one is from the 3D analysis, and we find out that the mean value of torque in 2D is about 6% higher than in 3D. And this comes from the three-dimensional effect. Also, the torque ripple is smaller in 3D. Now we take a look at the field results. We check the magnetic flux density. To get a feeling for the behavior of the flux density, we run an animation over the time steps. If we look into more details, we can see how the flux density has 3D effects. Thank you for your interest.